Hi there, I'm Alan Udy for the Historical Aviation Film Unit, and I'm here at Flair NZ at Te Kowhai Airfield near Hamilton in New Zealand, talking to Tony Unwin from Gyrate, New Zealand, about the Calidus Gyrocopter.
Okay, well, this aircraft is a development from the Auto Gyro Company in Germany. They've been producing this for the last 2 years. It's designed to provide some comfort and efficiency in the gyroplane world. Has all the attributes of a gyroplane. It won't stall, it won't spin, it lands at walking pace. Cruises around about 100 miles an hour in perfect comfort. Got heating on board, and you can equip it with all the latest technology in terms of radios and moving maps and that kind of thing. The Auto Gyro was developed in 1923 by a guy who was had just had a best friend killed in a fixed-wing aeroplane. In those days, stalling was a fairly common feature, and he went out of his way to try and develop a wing that wouldn't stall. And that's where the gyroplane was born. The wing rotates, and as long as there's air passing over the wing, it'll continue to fly. So it's not driven by the engine, it's driven by the air. And all we do is move the aircraft through the air. We're pushing on this one with a propeller at the back, pushing us along. If the engine stops, well, we just lower the nose and become a glider, and we're still pushing air over the wing. And so the wing works, rotates, and gives us lift right the way down to the ground, where we just flare, and as I say, the aircraft will land at walking pace.
We've certainly seen you around at air shows in New Zealand in the past, and from time to time we see auto gyros around. I suspect there are probably a lot more in the country than people realise. Is that the case?
Well, yes. For many, many years, well, the first ones I knew about were 1960s, where people were building their own machines, basically from a set of plans out of Popular Mechanics. And from that day onwards, people were teaching themselves to fly these auto gyros. Some were towed behind cars in the form of gliders being towed. And that was a good way to get a feel of a gyro before you put an engine on it and went flying. But yes, there's quite a few backyards and garages with possibly the remains of a few of these machines tucked away.
You mentioned this machine itself is from Germany. Are they big in Europe?
Yes, this company has produced 1,000 machines in the last 5 years. So their workforce has increased from about a core of 16 when I first knew them in 2004, 2005. They're now up to 100 people, and it's a really modern, expanding factory. Gyrate is a little company that we set up It served two purposes. One is that it allowed me to come and live in New Zealand and get a residency permit, but it also provides a one-stop shop for everything to do with gyroplanes. We teach people to fly, we do introductory flights, scenic trial flights around the mount, this kind of thing, and from there we hope people are going to be hooked enough to want to learn to fly gyros. They come along and learn with us, and then if they want to have their own machine and fly solo, then we can provide that for them, either in a new or second-hand machine.
You demoed yesterday and you're going to demo again today. For the uninitiated, it looks pretty extreme. What's your take on the demo?
No, the demo is well within the capabilities of the aircraft. We don't go anywhere near the limits of the envelope. The primary thing with a gyroplane is that it needs to have positive G at all times. That may sound a little technical, but basically you're encouraging the rotors to keep turning by pushing air through them. If you go negative, then the airflow goes the other way, comes down on top of the rotors, and they slow down, and that's doesn't make for a good day. So as long as we keep the positive G there, we can throw the airplane around in the confidence that it will enable us to put it on the ground at any time if we need to. Well, I believe that when you get a factory-made gyroplane and you get a professionally taught pilot, you've got probably the safest combination that you can get. And flying over New Zealand with some hostile terrain, it's a pretty good idea to have something that you're going to walk away from at the end of the day if all goes wrong.